Welcome to this Bend the Curve webcast. Bend the Curve is an educational campaign developed by NEHI with support from the WellPoint Foundation, aimed at providing healthcare leaders with actionable ways to reduce spending without impacting quality in an effort to create high-value healthcare. The campaign covers 7 critical areas of wasteful healthcare spending and seeks to provide health professionals with data to identify where costs can be reduced and recommendations for actionable solutions. In this webcast, we'll be looking at the problem of poor medication adherence. Targeting the $290 billion spent annually on medication adherence requires building on proven practices and implementing policy actions that target the root causes of the problem. These include care coordination strategies, patient engagement, and medication therapy management, among others. But before we talk about the tools healthcare leaders can utilize to improve medication adherence, we first have to talk about the size and scope of this very real healthcare issue. Tens of millions of Americans suffer from cardiovascular disease, diabetes, asthma, and other chronic conditions, resulting in billions of dollars in healthcare spending and significant morbidity and mortality. Despite the financial and human toll, many of these diseases can effectively be managed with the use of prescription medications. Unfortunately, many patients don't take their chronic disease medications as prescribed. In fact, almost 95 million Americans do not take their medications as prescribed by their doctors. The result? As many as 2 billion cases of poor medication adherence each year. Poor medication adherence costs the healthcare system a huge amount of money in a variety of different ways. Not taking medications as prescribed costs over $100 billion a year in excess hospitalizations. One example, it's been found that the total annual healthcare spending for a diabetes patient with low medication adherence, about $16,500, is almost twice as much as that for a patient with high adherence, less than $9,000. Furthermore, an estimated 89,000 premature deaths each year due to hypertension could be avoided with appropriate medication treatment. And diabetes and heart disease patients have also been shown to have significantly higher mortality rates for folks with low adherence than for similar patients who were adherent to their medications. The causes of poor medication adherence are complex and systemic. Some folks forego filling prescription for financial reasons. Others stop taking their pills due to side effects, and many others struggle with prescription regimens that can include multiple medications. But regardless of the reason, a medication not taken is an opportunity missed. Improving patient medication adherence requires building on a set of coordinated, proven practices in the field, coupled with policy actions in both the public and private sectors. The following slides talk a bit more about how these proven practices and policy actions can help to address this issue. One could argue that improving care coordination is central to addressing all 7 of the waste topics we've identified in the Bend the Curve campaign, as well as a lot of other issues in healthcare. However, improving care coordination is perhaps no more important anywhere than here in addressing poor medication adherence, as care teams composed of physicians, pharmacists, nurses, and other healthcare professionals have been shown to more effectively monitor adherence and counsel patients. For example, diabetes patients receiving care management are 21% more adherent to their medications than those who receive simply usual care. A renewed focus on the needs and abilities of patients is also required to address poor medication adherence. Specifically, discharge counseling and education and follow-up have been especially helpful in improving adherence. For example, elderly patients who receive pharmacist-led discharge counseling before they're let out of the hospital have been shown to improve their medication adherence by 43%. And patients with depression who are provided with educational materials and one-on-one follow-up have been shown to be twice as likely to refill their prescriptions as those who don't have that treatment and counseling. Medication therapy management, or MTM, has been essential to improving adherence. One study found that 56% of HIV/AIDS patients enrolled in an MTM program followed their medication directions, compared to only 38% of patients who didn't receive this approach. In addition, it's been demonstrated that patients with high blood pressure taking once-daily therapies are 11% more adherent than those who take twice-daily therapies for the same condition. Delivery system innovations, which focus on improving screening and assessment, have also been shown successful in addressing poor medication adherence and should be expanded. Examples such as the American Society of Health System Pharmacists Medication Reconciliation Toolkits, which promotes medication review and reconciliation, along with patient engagement, are perfect examples. Using technological interventions to address this problem is also important, and policy action should focus on investments in HIT, such as EHRs, e-prescribing, clinical decision support systems, and the sharing of data related to proper use of medications. A number of quality measures have been proposed regarding medication adherence over the last few years, with varying degrees of success. In turn, experts have recommended policy actions which encourage the adoption of consensus-based standards to measure the quality of adherence strategies, such as those from the National Quality Forum and the Pharmacy Quality Alliance. One final way to improve medication adherence that we've identified is the creation of financial incentives. There are a number of ways to go about this, but two of the most promising include establishing incentives for medication therapy management and eliminating copays for generic drugs. That brings us to the end of this Bend the Curve webcast. We hope that the webcast has been enjoyable and informative. If you'd like a copy of this presentation in PowerPoint form, or you'd like to learn more about this or any of the other Bend the Curve topics, please visit the website at www.nehi.net/bendthecurve. On the website, you'll find the Healthcare Leader's Guide to High-Value Healthcare, policy briefs, PowerPoint presentations, and more of these webcasts. We encourage you to use these tools to educate your colleagues, as well as to identify and implement successful solutions aimed at addressing the very real problem of healthcare waste in your organizations and communities. Thank you, and take care.